Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to talk about why blank appears in your slicer or filter. And the answer is single liner. Like if your fact table has a dimension member which is not exist in the dimension table, then a blank will appear. This is the only reason for it. And if you are not familiar with the fact dimension and you are not aware of modeling, let's try to check it out in the example and you will understand it better. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. What I'm trying to say, so we have your fact table here where typically it has a row number and product, year, location or different dimension reference, then amount and quantity is your numerical value or measures. Now the product is referring this team product table where you can have like A product has a two entries and B is sold three times and the product C is sold two times, whereas this product C does not exist in the dim product itself. This is the reason why any columns you use in the dim product in your slicer, a blank value will appear. This is the only reason the blanks will appear. This is what. Now we go back to the definition. Now you can see like fact table has a dimension member, that is value C, which is not exist in the dimension table. This C value is not exist in the dimension table. Then a blank will appear. Now we understand the problem, how to solve it. Let's go to our Power BI desktop and try to understand the problem once again with the data, and then we'll go for a solution. Now I have a simple model here. I have a sales, dim date, product master and location as well. Okay, so I will focus on the product master first, then we will try to understand other issues. So I have a product master, I mean the category name, it comes from the product master table, that is category name. So a blank appears, obviously it seems like there are some entries missing in the dim product. So this is the first thing you need to understand. So when you click on it, it works fine. As you can see, this order type is from the sales table. From the sales table I have taken it, so order type and quantity. Okay, so it works fine, but you can see still for the blank you have some orders as well, right? There are 282 quantities sold for the particular product or the category. So how to identify that? So basically, in order to identify, let's move on to this. This is not our focus. Actually, I just created how it will interact and work, right? So I will bring this one. In order to identify which products are not available in the dimension, just bring the key column, that is the product name. You can see here this product is joined with product name in the fact table, sales fact, and name in the product master. We will bring both the columns here. So just bring this product name from sales, which is having more records, and product and name from the product master. Now you can see this is the culprit, that is a chain. A product name chain does not exist in the product master. So in your case, in my case, I have only one entry, and in your case it can be many. So this name belongs to the product master, product name belongs to the sales fact table. So this chain appears in the fact table which does not exist. So how I can fix it? The only way you need to fix it, once you identify the which entry is missing, you need to add it in the dimension table. This is the dimension entry. I have already taken it. Just for this demonstration, I removed that. I will add it right now. Once I add it, now you can see this is the chain. I have added it and I saved this source file. Once I refresh this, you can watch this one, it will disappear. So it's loading. There you go. So you can see it has disappeared now. So this is how you can fix. Similarly, now here also, even the same thing, I have filtered some of the records for December. Now I will uncheck it. Like what I did is, like, I removed some of the entries in the date dimension, so that's why the blank appeared. So we can check it out, that issue, later. Now another important issue I want to highlight is, like, we will try to understand the location. Okay, here location is another filter. I will have the same format as a filter. Okay, I need to choose the filter. Now you see, when you see it as a data, it doesn't appear, but when you see it as a filter only, it appears as a blank. That's fine. So now what I'm trying to say, so in this location again there is a blank. Here it's a small catch here, like how you can identify. The same method you need to follow, like you need to use the location column from the fact table and location column from here. So here you can see the Hyderabad. This is the location that appeared in the fact table, and this location is from the dimension table. That is the order. You can see location dot location. When you go to this location dimension, to my shock, I already have this Hyderabad. The problem is, it is the spelling mistake. You can see Hyderabad. It is Hyderabad, whereas here Hyderabad. So I miss the E here. Okay, so that is why it considered it doesn't match. Okay, the matching should be same. So it should have a same name. Even if you have a spelling mistake, that is considered not exist. Okay, so this is the description. We will leave it as such. Now, once you go back and refresh your report, now let's see what happens. There you go. Now the blank disappeared and it has matched. So this is the only reason you will get blanks in your dimension table, that is as a slicer. There is no other reason it will have blanks over here. And another important thing I want to highlight is, like, this is typically when you have a star schema, if some member is missing in the dimension table, you will have. Sometimes you have your fat model where you have only single model, and you will use this particular column as in your slicer, and null appears over there. It means in your data you have blanks because you are not connected anything to dimension table, and you are using only single table, and you are using a directly some column in a slicer, and blank appears means your data itself having blank. You need to fix it. So this is the why you have your blanks in your slicer or filter, and how you can fix it. You just use the table visual to have the two columns, from one from dimension and one from the fact table, and identify which are the culprits and try to add them in the dimension table. And we are back to this page where I want to give you some quick trick on. Some people used to do this way, like, in order to avoid these blanks, like, right, you do not have time to fix it. So at that time, what you can do is you click on this and go to this filter pane and select all, uncheck the blanks. In this way, you are not filtering the entire thing here. I mean to say, like, this total is not affected, but you can see here this blanks is disappeared here. So in this way you can quickly work around this until you fix the actual data. And but this will not work out when you want to analyze the category also over here. What I'm trying to say is, I have a category and I want to analyze the quantity here, right? And you can press the quantity here. Now you can see still this will appear over here. So if you uncheck this value, that let me increase the size slightly so that you will understand what I'm trying to say. So if you do the same filter, you can say like, I will filter this one also. Like, so if you filter this, then your total won't match. Okay, so because all the totals should match across different dimension. So in this way, you will end up in confusion. People will start asking why this is 6 by 5 and why this is not. And you say enable blank, and you can say like, why blank appears here, why it is not appearing here. So it will end up in confusion. So if you use the same filters in the chart, this solution won't work on. This workaround should not be used. But for something you want a quick fix to be enabled, you can click on this visual and uncheck it. That will not affect any of your total, but you are again missing some of the filters, right? I mean, some of the categories you are hiding from the users. I hope you understand this, and if you want, you can use this trick as well. Like this video, hit the thumbs up button, and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.